Welcome everyone. In this series, I'm going to introduce you to the software I use to draw all my pixel art, ProMotion NG. When opening ProMotion NG, you are shown a home screen with a couple of elements. On the left, there is a list of project or asset files that have been used recently. On the right, you can see some news like recent updates and other information. If there is a new version available, a link will appear for direct download. Once you open a project, the other UI elements will become active. The main menu has some typical elements like File with functions to manage project files, Import/Export standard file formats, as well as Project Creation. Preferences and keyboard shortcut management can be found there as well. Menu Help gives access to documentation, video tutorials, online forum pages, and licensing options. On the left side, you find the toolbox with drawing functions and other options specialized for pixel art creation. At the top panel, there are two color slots used for drawing along with some extra functions described later. To the right, you have a brush tip selector and tip size definition, followed by the active color gradient and extra functions like color cycling and gradient management. Color cycling is a type of animation where the colors are rotated through pixels of a static image in a loop, giving different impressions of movement as shown in these examples. The Layers window provides the graphic layer management, where you can define layer order, opacity, blending, and add or remove layers and layer groups. The Tools and Paint Settings window provides extra options for the tool currently active, as well as global settings like paint mode options, snap grid, symmetry drawing, mouse control, or pen settings if you use a pressure-sensitive drawing tablet. Moving down, there is the brush container. You can store image and even animation portions like different variants of graphic elements. You can pick them quickly and use them again either in the same project or across projects. The brush container contents can be stored to files to build asset libraries or just to keep these objects along with the project. At the bottom, you find tabs containing the projects and files currently opened. The timeline represents the individual frames if you are creating animations, along with frame count, different playback control buttons, or playback range settings. At the far right, the playback speed can be defined, typically using an equal speed with a given number of frames per second, or individual frame display time in milliseconds. The color palette window has lots of functions to manage the colors an image may have. ProMotion NG works with so-called index colors. A pixel just defines which color of the 256 color palette is to be used. If you modify the color in the palette, then all pixels using this color index will reflect this change. The Edit tab opens extended color editing features so that you can easily arrange, copy, and move single or multiple colors within the palette, create color ramps, and more. The Animation Preview window is used to play back an animation and to show the artwork you are working on without zooming or with a more fixed zoom level compared to when navigating and drawing on the canvas, which is the last window, and located in the workspace center. You can rearrange the windows to your satisfaction. This is just the standard layout. In Menu, View, you can store different window layouts, and you can also reset to default layout settings, or let the windows align automatically based on some rough placement of the windows in left, middle, and right area. If you're interested in learning more, then please subscribe, and of course I'm happy if you give a like. Thanks for watching.